Hi, my name is Sven Nolsen, and in this video we will look at attachments and meshes. As you might remember from the basic concepts video, attachments in spine are attached to bones via slots. When the bones are transformed, any attachment attached to the bones are also transformed. Attachments can be both visual, such as images or meshes, or conceptual, like a bounding box. It's also possible to change which attachment is visible for a given slot by using the visibility dot in the tree. A region attachment is a simple rectangular image attached to a bone. It gets the name region because at runtime it is typically drawn using a region from a texture atlas. Region attachments are created from images under the images node in the tree and has a number of properties shown in the bottom. Attachments under the same slot must have unique names, but they can have different paths. When path is left blank, the attachment name is used to find the attachment image. You can view the images video for details on exactly how attachment images are found. Color is used to tint the region attachment. However, the color on the region attachment cannot be changed during animation. To do that, instead set the color on the slot. When background is checked for region attachment in the properties, the region attachment can no longer be selected and won't be exported. This can be convenient for images used as reference, such as background images, or fully assembled skeletons to use as a template. Optionally, you can set the color in the region attachment to more easily distinguish it from the rest of the images. A region attachment's transform can be copied by selecting the attachment and pressing Ctrl+C, and then later applied to another region by selecting it and pressing Ctrl+V. This sets scale, rotation, and translation to the copied values. Another way to copy the transform of a region attachment is to drag and drop one attachment onto another. Doing this will change the dragged attachment to have its transform match the attachment it was dropped on. Meshes allow a polygon to be defined inside an image, and these polygons can be manipulated to bend and deform the image in powerful ways. Meshes also have the advantage that the polygon can exclude blank space in an image, and this reduces fill rate usage and can increase performance since you're drawing fewer pixels, potentially allowing you to draw more pixels elsewhere. To create a mesh, first create a region attachment from an image under the Images node, and then check Mesh in the properties of the region attachment. This converts the region attachment to a mesh with four vertices, one for each corner. Clicking the Edit button enters edit mode, where the entire undeformed image is then shown. In this mode, the mesh vertices represent the mesh's texture coordinates, also known as UVs. Edit mode has three tools. First one is Modify, which allows vertices and edges to be translated by dragging. Note that multiple vertices can be selected by holding down Ctrl. Create allows you to create new vertices by clicking, or new edges to be created by dragging. Delete will let you delete vertices by clicking, or you can select multiple vertices by holding Ctrl. With any of the tools active, vertices can also be deleted by double-clicking, and right-clicking will switch tools. Clicking the reset button replaces all vertices with 4 vertices, one for each corner. The generate button adds new vertices to the mesh, both inside and along the edges. Using generate on a mesh that has vertices in each corner will create a uniform grid. Clicking it multiple times will add more and more vertices. Generate won't change vertices along the boundary edge of a mesh, but any vertices inside the mesh will be deleted. You can exit edit mode at any time by pressing spacebar or escape, or by clicking the edit button in the properties at the bottom of the tree, or by closing the edit mesh dialog. Also, the outline view can be useful to visualize the mesh while tweaking the UVs. So, thanks for watching. I hope you found the video useful. In the next video, we will go into more detail on meshes.